guys, and welcome back to another video. Today we're going to be doing another scenario for the Bakerloo Line on Train Sim World 2. This time we're going to be taking on the taking stock scenario, which where we have to take control of a southbound train to Queen's Park from Harrow and Wolseley. So let's do this, and while we wait I will give a shout out to the supporters of the channel, who are Ferren and James. If you do want to be a supporter of the channel, then you will need to click on the join button just under the video, and yeah. Taking stock. Welcome to Harrow and Wilton. This southbound service will only be operating as far as Queen's Park. Open the doors to commence boarding. Will do once it lets me. Okay, let's put the destination as Queen's Park. Queen's Park. Lights are on. Yep. Okay, so that's how you disable that hissing sound. So we didn't reset the valve, so. Okay, now I know. Which is good. The speed limit is 45 miles an hour. Is Kenton. Okay, let's lock the doors. Ah, man, I keep doing the wrong. Okay, let's get going. station is South Kensington. This is the Bakerloo Line service to Queen's Park. I like how there's like a red signal and yellow signal on the West Coast Main Line tracks, but there's literally no AI trains on those lines. It's kind of pointless, I would say. Now approaching South Kensington. On the right hand side. Why is this camera here? Oh, there we go. Are the rear lights on? I might have forgot. Yeah, they're on. Okay, let's lock the doors. Next station is North Wembley. And then that's faster than max brakes, I think. It's interesting. Yeah, we overshot, unfortunately. I mean, apart from that front door, then it's not too bad. Left end doors. Thinking about this train is that the brakes are too good. You think that you can like break the last minute and sometimes like you overshoot it. At least you know if you have bad brakes then you can brake a bit early as you approach the station. Next station is Bermuda Central, where you can change for London Underground services and National Rail services. So I said that one actually finally connects a lot on this route. We haven't actually explored much. But like in the previous video, I will be live streaming this weekend, so stay tuned for that. But we might do a little bit of gameplay, but realistically we're just going to be exploring, finding these collectibles. have been a bit short, but let's see what happens. No, we're good actually. This platform is actually really big. Yep, we're good. Fortunately, these scenarios don't let us like explore, because literally within like 30 seconds we have to lock the doors and continue, so. Next station is Stonebridge Park. This train is ready to depart. Please mind the doors. doors. Yeah, the platform's actually huge, so they're good. So some of you have mentioned that the game volume is too loud and you can't hear me. I'm actually not too sure what to do about that, because if I put the game volume any lower, then you probably won't be able to hear the game sound too well, and then obviously you might hear me properly, but obviously you need to hear the game sound as well, so it's a bit of a hard compromise. I mean, the train sounds amazing, I want you guys to hear it. Open. Okay, next station is Kensal Green. Thank you. feel like part of the train's in the tunnel still, so we can't go external camera. But this train is ready to depart. These minor doors. Approaching Wilson Junction. The train terminates, all change, won't change. If you wish to get a train towards Elephant and Castle, please stay on the same platform. And hopefully another train behind us will go all the way to Elephant Castle. Fix that issue. Anyways, let's just sit down. I'm not sure why we're loading passengers since this train has terminated, but okay. Locking the doors. Okay, stop at the shed, which is just 200 yards ahead, so. Towards Harrow Wilson, so interesting set the traction brake control to shut down, okay. I'm not entirely sure how to do that, but it's this one. Not too sure actually. Shut down here. Nope. Traction brake control. Actually, not too sure how to do this, guys. Okay, so it wants me to do on what? Shut down. Done it. Oh, one sec, I think I'm doing the wrong thing. Ah, there we go. Sit in the driver's seat at the other end of the platform. Okay then. Guess we're doing a few other things. So let's open this. I guess you can just walk through the train. Not too sure why there's passengers here, but I guess we're gonna go back towards Queen's Park. And another driver will take over or something, I'm not too sure. I can actually open the windows on the door, that's actually really cool. Got two trains together basically, so once this go right to the front, I guess the passengers can close these doors if they want. Actually, I can sprint. Well, I'm not sprinting. There you go. Sit down. The thing is, you have to stand up to do it, which is stupid. It is on, isn't it? Insert the driver selected to enter. Inside, is it? Set the traction brake control to off and release. Okay then. Oops, that's not what I want to do. Operating an empty coach stop back to Stonebridge Park Deep. I didn't actually realize. Okay, this is platform. Weird in the Bakerloo Line because Bakerloo Line obviously stops at all stations. Space at Queen's Park, so we're heading back up to Stonebridge Park Depot. Just hit 11:01 in the night. What if I should do is on the lights? Let me do that. So yeah, I can even see something. I lost on one night. function. Are you serious? Wow. Maybe we can load the last checkpoint, I'm not too sure. It said go via Stonebridge Park, so I'm not too sure. Got my map on there, guys. Hopefully the checkpoint's not too far away. Okay, checkpoints here. Perfect. Oh, that's pretty good actually. I'm glad the checkpoint's literally here. Okay, we're gonna have to wait for this red signal. Denied. That was actually crazy. I'm glad there's checkpoints in this game, because otherwise we would have just failed the scenario right to the end. Which wouldn't be very nice. I'm not too sure how long we have to wait actually. still denied. This one you go explore. Oh, it doesn't let me. Wow, you can't actually go any further than this from the train. That's really stupid. I'm literally only here and the trains are there. At least we can see Wembley Stadium over there. Can I go? Oh, we're waiting for that train, that makes sense. We're waiting for this service, which is heading towards. And it'd be awesome. Should be good now. Yep, there we go. Nice. Speed limit of, is it 10 miles an hour? Yeah, 10 miles an hour is coming up. To go via the train watch. I think checkpoints wasn't in Train Sim World 1, I'm pretty sure. Because I did fail some scenarios on that game and I wasn't able to replay them. I had to do it all over again, which was quite annoying. Wanted to go a bit faster than that. Wow, it literally wants me to go 3 miles an hour at the moment, which is really stupid. Am I not in real life? It's like this, but you know, this is just a bit long, I would say. I mean, surely it can't be 3 miles an hour while we have to travel 600 yards, that's like really long. I think as we go through the train watch, then it will change, I'm pretty sure. Wait, is that 5 miles an hour or 3 miles? I think that's 5 actually. Yeah, speed limit is 5. I thought it was actually 3 miles an hour for a minute. Not too sure how going 5.0 miles an hour in a 5 miles an hour speed zone is considered speeding, but okay. all counts. Nope, it wants a score even forward, so let's do that. There we go. I think for the most part we performed pretty well, but did speed a bit. Is that a gold? Yeah, that is a gold, nice. And we've hit level 10 as well. I'll take that. But yeah guys, hopefully you guys enjoyed it. If you did, give it a like, share with your friends, and I will see you in my next video. Bye guys.